Hey guys and welcome to this video. Today I want to show you the particle behind person effect. First of all, drag and drop the background clip into the timeline. Now search for a scene on which you want to apply this effect. So after you found your scene, you have to cut out your scene as a clip. Then you have to export your clip in Davinci Resolve and go to runwayml.com to rotoscope your person. Go click this link if you don't know how to rotoscope in Runway. After you rotoscoped your person, go back into DaVinci Resolve and drag and drop the rotoscope version into the timeline. After that, go into Fusion. Press Shift and Spacebar at the same time and search for Delta Gear. Select Delta Gear and press Add. Now click on this little background color field. Then you have to pick your screen color and go to your green screen and press left click. Then hit the OK button. Go back into the Edit page. And here you have to duplicate your rotoscope clip by pressing Alt and your left mouse button. Drag the upper clip to the right, go to this rotoscope clip and go into Fusion. Now again, press Shift and Space by the same time and search for P-Emitter. Select P-Emitter and press Add. Now with P-Emitter selected, go to Region and change the region from Sphere to Bitmap. Now you have to disconnect this little arrow and connect the Delta Gear node with the P-Emitter node. So now at P-Emitter, go to Controls and change the number to 5000. Increase the number variance a little bit as well as the position variance. Then change the color to Use Color from Region and go to Velocity. Here you have to increase the velocity as well as the velocity variance. And after that, change the angle to minus 90. Now go to Style and go to Fade Controls. Set the out value to 0.8 and go back to region. Also change the high value to 0.8. Okay, that's everything for the P emitter. Now press again Shift and Spacebar and search for P Turbulence. Select this option and press Add. So now with P Turbulence selected, go to Controls and change the random seed to 1000. Also change the set strength value to 0.3. Then increase the density to 30. And after that, again, press Shift and Spacebar at the same time and search for P-Render. Select P-Render and press Add. The only thing that matters here is that the output mode should be 2D. Again, press Shift and Spacebar and search for Color Corrector. Select Color Corrector and press Add. Now connect the Color Corrector node with the Media Out node. And now you should see this particle pile. So if you want to change the color of these particles, then you only have to go to the color corrector node. And with that selected, you only have to change the color on the color field. And yes, I really like the blue effect of the particles. And go back to your edit page. And here you can drag the upper clip back to the left. Then go back to your particle clip and change the composite mode from normal to add. But you don't really need to do this. I've done this because the particles get brighter. And if you have some problems with the green screen of your upper clip, then go to your upper clip and go into Fusion. And here you can try to play around with the gain and the balance sliders. So I changed my balance to 0 and because of this the transparent background in the middle gets removed. Or you can change the background color a little bit. So all in all, I hope this tutorial has helped you. If so, then leave a like or sub to my channel. Thanks for your attention, stay creative and bye!